lot of people get confused about Gumball and don't know how to use it. Today I'm going to show you two things about Gumball. First, basic move, rotate, and scale. Second, we are going to use the Gumball to create very crazy form. Are you ready? Let's get started. It is convenient to use Gumball because you can see everything in a perspective view, so that's enlarge the perspective view. In the Gumball, there are three things you want to look at it. First is the arrow. The arrow mean is move. So you can move it freely like this, or you can type it any of the number and hit enter. And then so that will move exactly certain unit that you wanted. Notice that there are little window right there. So in this window, you can see the blue and also the green and that little square window there. So if you move that, you are moving in these two axes at the same time. Now let's look at the arc. You have this arc there that again coming three different color, that means rotation. So you can rotate it freehand like this way, or you can just type it, click on it and type it a certain degree, let's say 45, and then you can rotate it into that certain degree that you want it. Now going back to the little dot with this square there, this mean scale. Alright, so you can do 1D scale. If you holding the shift and drag that little square, then you are doing the 3D scale. If you like to do 2D scale, come back to this little window there. You're holding the shift and drag it, and that will allow you to do 2D scale. So you have scale for 1D by just dragging this little square, or you can scale for 2D and then by holding the shift, and then you can drag it for 2D. Or you like to do 3D scale, then holding the shift and drag this little square, so you can do 3D scale. Now let's talk about moving the Gumball. Gumball is preset right in the center of my object. If I'm going to rotate, it's going to rotate in this way using the center as the pivot point. What if I do not want to rotate over there? I want to use one of the edges as my rotating center as a pivot point. What I can do is, if you look at the Gumball, there's a little white spot right there. If you right click on the Gumball, and then you're gonna come up a little window. We wanna click relocate Gumball. Now my off snap is on, my endpoint is on. I'm going to snapping into this endpoint and then snapping into another endpoint. It come up, you can see it is duplicated. Or give you a preview of what it's going to look like. I was preset one of the axes, and then I'm going to click on this endpoint. Now my Gumball is right there. If I'm go ahead to rotate, then I will able to get the rotation like this way. And again, you can type any of the number for the specific rotation angle. Now I'm done with this, and I want to move a Gumball back to the center. Again, I right click on the white dot and I can say reset the Gumball. So Gumball will reset it back to the center. Then I can keep editing on this guy. Now let's take a look on Gumball's copy function. If we click on the object, and while we are dragging it, before we release our mouse, we hit the Alt key, A-L-T, on your keyboard. You will see a plus sign showing right here, and then you release your mouse, then you will get a copy of the original shape. When you have multiple objects, that the Gumball will be right in the center for single object, and if you holding the shift and click on the other one, then you will have the Gumball right in the middle of them. So when you try to duplicate it, again, you will hit the Alt key. It will duplicate both of them at the same time. And then if you choose all four of them, then Gumball will be right in the center of all those four objects. You could reset the Gumball again to any of the edges by going to relocate the Gumball, and then you can set it, for example, right here. Now, if I want to rotate it, I will able to rotate it all of them at once. Here's one of the interesting functions that Gumball has. As you click on any of the plane that you have, and then you can see this blue arrow come with the little dot. So if you drag the dot, it will give you an extrusion out of the surface you just have. Now, I'm going to click on the whole things again. There's no little dot showing up because I cannot extrude it the whole solid. However, if I hold the Control and the Shift key and I click on this surface, you will see that the single surface being selected from the entire solid. And then I can drag in that again, then that will give me an additional extrusion from there. Now we have a two extrusion and it is a single solid, but it does has a seam right in the middle. So what you can do is Control and Shift again, and let's click on this surface and let's extrude that. So now you have a shape coming out of the other shape. What else can we do with that extrusion? Let me select the surface one more time with Control and Shift, and then I would like to scale it down, so I'll scale it up or down, and we will have some shape like this. Notice that the rest of the shape will follow it. Even more, what we can do is we can rotate the shape like this one. So now that face is facing into an angle, I can click on the face with Control and Shift and try to drag it. Let's say I do not want to drag it into this direction. I do want to drag it to where that face is facing to. What I can do is I want to click up these faces and right in the middle, right click and hold it, and then you will see this little window coming up. I want to relocate the Gumball, and let's say we're going to snapping into this point to this point. So that way we will have it face the Gumball facing the direction with the faces facing to, and we can extrude it more to getting more of the shape. And or we can moving that shape into whatever angle that we wanted to have. The Gumball also applied to the curve. If I pick up this curve, and you can see I have the extrude option, that little dot on the moving arrow, then I will get this surface. So notice that what we had there earlier is we have a square surface, and then when we extruded the surface, we get a solid. Now if we extruded a curve, let me do one more time, if we extruded the curve, we get a surface. So that is a big difference right there. Gumball extrusion is not only applied to the poly surface, it's also applied to the mesh. If you look at the property right here for this mesh, it is a closed mesh. So I would like to do some change on this mesh, and I will do the same. I will hold on the Control and Shift, and I will click on these faces. Notice that it's turning into the yellow. Then I will go into extrude it out, and everything should follow with it. It should be the same method. Just be careful, don't overplay it, otherwise it will break your mesh. And let's take a look, it is still closed mesh. Let me know how you feel about a Gumball. Is that gonna help you on your model? Type your question and comment below. I will get back to you soon. See you next.